I can take you somewhere. Unfortunately, it's just one person, so there's more than beat me up. But you know, it's getting there. And that has every implication to networking and every implication to what we need to for feeds and speeds, especially if we're talking about 5G. Every implication to technology that's required from a networking perspective. The cloud is so clear, and it has every implication to your workforce. So what's being done by drones, you know, by humans, and now replaced by drones, where are you going to be at? How are you going to continue with your skill sets? Interesting space. I love it. So the workforce is indeed, when we talk about digitization, it comes down to this. What is the country's digitization strategy? What does it mean from an education perspective? What does it mean from a research perspective? What does it mean for the benefit of its communities? What does it mean in terms of how you are going to make sure that your community, that your employee, that your citizens are actually skilled? This is extraordinarily important. Every country that I talk to, really, where leaders are very concerned about this space. I will say that, you know, it's never, ever too late to learn, especially when you're on the factory floor. It's never too late. So robotics are here. By the way, let me take a step on robotics. Japan is the most aging society in the world. And they have a huge amount of research in robotics. And what they're doing is taking these robots and actually placing them with senior citizens. Now, they're not gotten to the point where the robots can pick up the elderly person to actually wash, but they haven't gone to that space yet. But you know what? The elderly people, because Japanese culture, they look at these robots as spiritual beings, this animism. They believe that spirits are within these people. So within these, look, I just call them robot a person. But I mean, that's a Freudian slip. It's, you know, anthropomorphic, but it's really important. So robotic research, very, very high, because now they're creating what we call virtual artificial companionship. Absolutely. So that's a very, very, very interesting space for what we're doing in Japan, robots. Now, top 10 skills. I'm going to tell you, 2020, I'm going to tell you now, it's called skill number six. Emotional intelligence. Number one, you can call it a T profile, you can call it being deep, you can call it being broad, but interdisciplinary skills are really required. Study computer science and engineering. Oh, by the way, please study anthropology and social science. And oh, by the way, people will say that may be something called collaboration. Associated with women. But it's a big currency. It's a huge currency. I was at the Grace Hopper Women in Computing Conference last week in Houston, and I heard Google X's Ashton Teller speak. And he said, that's important. They look for people with mixed skills, some notion of emotional intelligence. Joyce actually had something in her slide that was extraordinarily interesting. And she said, women are really great in conflict management. In fact, how many of you have heard of Resolution 1325? Resolution 1325, enacted on October 1st in the year 2000, UN resolution, was to get more women in conflict resolution when you're talking about wars at the table. And the reason why it hasn't gotten more active today is because the feedback is women would compromise. I think we would be in a little peaceful world today if that were more inhabited. So, thank you. And I think that's, and we're going to see that more and more happen. One thing I'll say about collaboration, and this is really important. Remember, I said it's not a zero, it's a win-win. How many of you use WebEx? Okay. I was on a WebEx call, subject matter expert on this call. I was on this WebEx call, and WebEx has the capability of you raising your hand virtually. Well, the moderator lost total control, and I'm raising my hand. And, you know, people are getting, I mean, first of all, it was interesting, I was the only woman on the call. I was the subject matter expert, and I'm raising my hand. And these lovely guys are just getting excited about the technology. They're like, mmm. You know what? I got so bored, I hung up, but I hung up the entire conference call. I didn't know that. So, but I told them they were wasting my time. But anyway, the notion is we're in this world together. EQ, and emotional intelligence is a huge currency in this 21st century. Huge. Skills gap, I can tell you in Europe, and I know you know this very well. That's a big gap, and it's a gap not only in Europe, in the United States, and I love what Dubai is. I love what the UAE is doing, because they're going in and just being declarative about the digital nation, but it is a huge skills gap. A view in the future, because I want to give you a view in the future. Remember, 1 trillion sensors. We can talk about big numbers now. New jobs. Here are new jobs. So, system anthropologist. How many of you have anthropology as a background? Get it. I was recently, 2 weeks ago, at Canberra, Australia, as a guest of Australian National University, the School of Engineering. And the dean of that School of Engineering is the first female dean in its history. In fact, I think globally throughout the world, in one hand, you can count female deans of schools of engineering. Okay, in one hand. She's one of them. Her name is Eleanor Huntington, a physicist. You know what she's doing? She's going to have an anthropologist and an ethnographer in the School of Engineering. She is going to actually embed that, a faculty member, because they believe it's not just computer science, it's not just engineering, it has got to be from the lens of an ethnographer. How do you use the technology? Right here in Dubai, how should I use the technology? How should I use it? So that is a huge, interesting skill that's going to be developed, or a huge, I would say, profession that's going to be developed. And by the way, it's really interesting when you talk to the PhD students, you know, every one of them know that they know by heart the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. What is number 5? There you go. And they know each one of them, and what they're trying to do is anything they do research on, they map it to the goals. So it's really extraordinary what's happening at ANU. The other thing is, how many of you are familiar with freeformers? Right. Freeformers, remember the youth. There are youth coming up. And this is a great program out of the UK trying to make it global. But what about the youth who have been passed from one system to another? They don't have a high school education. Or you have a degree that can't get your foot into the door. Freeformers is excellent. What they do is they come up to Joyce and they say, this is the interview process. What are you passionate about? And Joyce says, agriculture. And the interview is, well, the response is teach us. The premise is, I can teach you technology in 6 weeks. I can get you your foot to the door. The presentation skills, and by the way, these are people who have been passed from one orphanage to another, or one home, or some of them are homeless. And what they do is in 6 weeks, they teach you, and then what do? There's a video, you should see it. Goes into the CEO of Barclays Bank, and teaches that CEO how to code a mobile app. And it's a very interesting app. It's actually an app for banking in one day. And what happens? That CEO falls in love with her or him. And he's hired. So that's another form of education and another form of taking it from another level. So while we have people who are in school, I'm suggesting there are people who are not in school that, and this group, that can actually be benefit from this type of thing. There you go. Well, you know what? It's a great time. It's a beautiful time. We're in beta. Beta testing. The world is in beta, as we speak. And it's incumbent upon you women to take us further to the 21st century. It's incumbent upon you to do that. It's incumbent upon the men in the room to be the power of the end. The men in the room here is the power of the end. Because we can't stand up here in the 21st century and still talk about this stuff. So you have to be declarative about the role you're going to play. It is hugely exciting, and I want to thank you very much. Any questions? Comments?
Two questions.
Excited? Motivated? After Joyce, anybody can be motivated. We've got to go. All right. Thank you.
Was Monique phenomenal?
Yes.
So Monique, if this group's a little shy, we found that out yesterday too, about asking questions. Is there a burning desire question? Someone? Yes. Good.
Is this better now? A lot, 80% of women have been marginalized by corporate career paths. And they end up flying solo. This is the glass ceiling phenomenon, right? In Europe, 85% of single proprietorship enterprises are women-led. And 85% of women-led enterprises are solo operations. In the US, it's even higher numbers. And I think it's a global phenomenon. How much are they contributing to the economy? How many jobs are they creating? We don't know. How do we get them into the